For I know the thoughts that I think towards you, said the Lord, thoughts of peace and not of evil, to give you an expected end.
I've seen so many people who know this scripture, Jeremiah 29:11. I know the thoughts I think towards you. I know the plans that I have for you. Have you heard this before?
Yes, yes. This is one of my favorite ones.
Yes. And many people think that this scripture will come to pass. Because God has got great plans for me. Plans for my peace, plans for my welfare, and not for my destruction. But yet, in spite of quoting this scripture, it looks like the plans of Satan are being accomplished. And then comes the question, why? Will this scripture come to pass?
Brother, it says in 29:13.
Surely God has got great plans. Sorry?
It says in 29:13, and you shall seek me and find me when you search me with all your heart.
Yeah, but if you take that 29:11, will that come to pass?
Yes.
Will it come to pass?
Yes, brother.
It won't come to pass until I agree to what the teachings of Christ is. That is why many times people quote the scripture, but being ignorant of the teachings, okay?
Okay.
They experience extreme disaster. I'll give you an example. Yesterday was my nephew's roast. So I was going on the bike, and those are from just before coming to Panjim, they have made a new flyover.
Yes.
So I was on the bike and I took the flyover. I crossed the other side, and the cop was waiting for me, and he stopped me and he said, don't you know that bikes are not allowed on the flyover? I said, no, I don't know. So he asked me for the license and he said, sorry to say, 700 rupees fine and 6 months license suspended.
What?
So I said, that is because of my ignorance. I would have never taken the flyover if I knew. And then he looked at me, he asked me from where I am and all that. And then he let me go. He did not charge me. Praise God. But what I want to say, if I knew the rule, I wouldn't have taken the flyover. Yes. Who wants to pay the fine? At the same time, the license suspended for 6 months.
True.
In the same way, we are living in the world, but we are not of the kingdom of the world. We are of the kingdom of God. So the rules and regulations are entirely different for the kingdom of God and the kingdom of the world. And the kingdom of the world knows that if this person starts living under the system of the kingdom of God, this person cannot be stopped. This person is victorious. This person can go and destroy the kingdom of darkness everywhere he marches into. Because the teachings of Jesus can never fail. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Whatever Jesus taught, he applied. And he lived a victorious life without failure. So, just by quoting the scripture that God has got great plans for me, plans for my welfare and not for my destruction, will not bring the result. Yesterday I met some family members, and one person said he was in huge debts. And there was no way he could ever come out. And 10 years back, somebody from the team had preached him on sower and the seed and said the word of God is a seed. But this seed needs to be planted in good soil. And when you plant it in a good soil, it will produce the harvest. And he said, I'll give you a seed which you'll have to say every day that I will lend and not borrow all the days of my life. I will lend and not borrow all the days of my life. At the same time, he began to listen to the word of God, the teachings, began to renew his mind. God is life renewed. God is life changed. And he kept on saying this. During the lockdown, when every business was closed, his business was flourishing. He said that God says that Jesus said, I've come to give life, life in abundance. He said, I did not know the word abundance till this lockdown. God gave me so much of business that I was tired in counting the money. Can you believe that?
Praise God. Yes.
I was tired in counting the money. And in these 2 years, God got me not only out of the loan, it gave me so much of surplus. I just want to thank God for that seed he sowed in the seed and teaching me how my words are seeds. And he went on praising and talking to me about what the word of God has been doing in his life. Now, was he praising from his heart? Yes. But when he got the seed, was he praising from the heart? No, it was sorrowful. But as he continued to listen to the word, what did the word do? The word gave him the knowledge of right and wrong. And as he began to go on the path of righteousness, he discovered God's big plan, not only to bring him out of debts, but also to bless him tremendously. He's saying, today I become a generous giver. I keep giving and keep giving to the old age orphanage and this and that. And he said, there's so much of joy now. Once upon a time, I had all the selfish ideas. Now it is all kingdom. So you see, even though I can say God has got great plans for me, those plans don't come to pass until I apply the kingdom principles.